So, you have an Etsy store with all your beautiful products in it. Now you need to start selling them. One of the best ways to market your Etsy products for free is by using Pinterest marketing. You could create and upload Pinterest pins for your Etsy products one by one, but this takes forever. I'm going to show you how you can make hundreds of Pinterest pins in seconds for your Etsy products so that you can start selling more. And I'm going to tell you how in 30 seconds. Starting now. Step 1, log on to pingenerator.com. Step 2, copy and paste the URL of your Etsy shop into Pin Generator. Step 3, click Generate and watch your new Pinterest pins arrive. Step 4, edit your pins so that the colors, fonts, and templates are perfect. Step 5, send your pins directly to Pinterest or schedule them to be sent later. So let's slow down a bit and go through each of the pieces of functionality more slowly so that you can get a grip for what the system's about. So this is the URL, pingenerator.com. And basically, you can put in any URL you want here and generate Pinterest pins for it. So what the system does is the URL that you give it, it goes to that website's page and it looks at all the images on that website's page. So it'll grab all of the images for that website's page. It also looks at the page's description and title and uses those as your pin's description and title. So for instance here, we have Spotlight Jewelry. This is somebody else's Etsy store that I'm using as an example, Kat Hutchins, well done. So we just take the URL of that store. On the front page here, you can select different template sets. I quite like this one. And we can post the URL of that store in here and generate pins. So this will take us to the pin generating page. This is where all the magic happens. And now we just wait for our pins to arrive. So it has a default number of pins 10 set, but you can increase or decrease this. But and obviously it'll take a little bit longer the more you have. So just bear that in mind. So now you can see a whole bunch of pins have been created according to the templates we set up, and it has all the images from this web page. Cool, fantastic. So we can see that the title here is actually the title of this page. So we might want to change that in future. And we can do that by editing the pin here and simply changing this here. Test, test, test. Or cool jewelry, jewelry. Never known as for jewelry. So you can edit that there. And you can see that the font at the bottom here is etsy.com. So that's normally a nice way to promote your website. Or the name of your store even. So you could change this to Spotlight, GHT, Jewelry. So you can make that whatever name you like. Then in the pin description, this will be the description that people see on the Pinterest pin. So you can change that to fit whatever description you like. You can also make sure to target the keywords that you're looking for in both the pin title and the description. That really helps. Then of course you have the pins outbound link in Pinterest. So that's where when a user clicks on the pin, that's where they're gonna go after they follow the outbound link. And then in this section here, you can also select different types of templates for your pin, and you can choose different images to suit whatever pin you wanna promote. You can click save to save it. Cool, so that's how you edit an individual pin. Now, you can also, on the pin, you can move your image around to fit the screen as you wish. So here you go, if you wanna make it fit a little bit more snug like that. I have a white background set here. So one of the cool things is that we have, in the fonts and colors, the image background color here, you can set that to whatever you like. So if you wanted to match it to that blue there, you could set it to a similar blue. Can't really match it perfectly, but you get the idea. I like to have white there so that it just frames everything in a cool white color, which is nice and easy. So coming through here, if you like these pins and you've pinned them all and it's time to get a new set, this button here is a really cool way to shuffle your pins and to generate a whole new set really quickly. So you just click that, boom, and then you've got a whole bunch of new pins with different images all shuffled in new templates, and it's a great way to create new, unique, and fresh pins, which is what Pinterest loves. So this shuffle button is really gold and just creating new pins over and over. So these pins are generated for the homepage of Spotlight Jewelry. If you want to create pins for a specific category or a specific product, all you have to do is click on the category itself, copy the URL, and paste and generate. So now this should generate all pins for images within the rings category, all these images that you can see here. So here we go, View Rings by Spotlight Jewelry on Etsy. So that's the name of it. So you have to have all these things coming up. Or alternatively, you can click on a specific ring. I like this one. Let's have a look at that. So here it is. We can copy the URL here, simply paste it in there, and then we should get the Birthstone Death Hand Moth ring. There we go. So now we have all of the images specifically for that Birthstone Death Hand Moth ring here. And we can see all the images that the site has picked up by looking through here. So then when you want to set the board you want to pin to, you can click, you know, after you've synchronized your Pinterest account, all your boards will appear here. You just select whatever board that you want here. I'm just going to select Bali because it's the random one I have available. And then we have a couple of options. So we can pin the image directly to Pinterest. Now that's going to pin this pin image directly to this board here, Bali. Or you can schedule the pin for later. So if you click the schedule pin, it'll save the pin and it'll set it up to be posted at a certain schedule time. So that schedule time can be governed here in your schedule pin settings. So if you look at the schedule pin settings, here's the pin that we just scheduled, and it's been scheduled out for 2 in the morning, 21st of April, 2022. So you'll realize that on the generate page, you didn't select this time. And that's so that we can make scheduling even easier. So make scheduling a one-click functionality where you just click schedule once and it goes. So what we do is we set up the pin scheduling settings one time, and then all pins are sent out according to the pin scheduling settings that we've created. So it's kind of like smart scheduling. So we set the number of pins that we want to pin per day, and then we set the times that we want to post these pins between. So I've got it set to between 2 a.m. and 4 a.m. and 8 p.m. and 11 p.m. And my time zone is US Pacific time. So once we've set up our settings like we like, maybe we want to say, let's say 10 pins a day, and we want to change it to 6:30 and 10, and we save the settings. Cool. So now you'll see here that our posting interval, this means that we'll post a pin every 33 minutes. So that's cool. And these are the times that our pins will go out in. So now the first time we schedule a pin, it'll go out at 2. And the next time we click schedule, it'll go out at 2:33 and so on. So that's how the pin scheduling settings work. It's how you set it up. So let's go back to generate pins where we have all our pins that we generated here. We can schedule a few more just as an example. And so this takes the image and gets it ready for scheduling. We'll just wait for these turners to turn so we know it's done. And then we come back here and we see all of our pins here and the times they're going out and the board that they're going to be pinned to. And if you don't like any, you can simply just delete it here. All right, let's go back to the generate. So here we are. Here are a few more little things that we can use to make our pins perfect. We can set the specific colors we want. So let's say we want to change this blue to a red. Okay, we're going to go select a red here. Lovely, that looks good. Or we can select one of the preset colors here that I've set up that I just like. You can select one of those there. So now you have this array of colors. So this array of colors lets you have a bunch of colors for your templates. But if you only want to use one color, you can uncheck this use all colors box, and then it'll use all the same color of the color that you've selected. Cool. So I like to use all colors though, because it creates a nice variety. This font color is the color that your font is going to be. Also, so there's a couple of templates with default font colors. and which goes nicely with it. So like purple here with a purple background, so it's matching. But if you want to override this, you can simply set your font color to whatever font color you like. I prefer to use the defaults though. Then you have your image background color, like I showed you. You can also change your font type to match your style or whatever you'd like. You can set it to use uppercase or lowercase font. And this is font sizes, font weights, you get the idea. Then we have the pin templates. So there's a bunch of different templates that you can choose from. You can completely randomize these templates, which is a fun way to just create new pins and have designs serve to you. Or you can specify the ones you really like. So I like a couple. I like this one, that one. Those are probably my favorites. Nice and wavy and quite square. So you can select the templates that you like. We've got a bunch of templates there to select from. Then you can also randomize images, which just grabs a new image for that template, but keeps the template the same. We also have a setting that if you want your products to be, you know, if you feel like they're being overlapped, we have a setting that's where you can contain the images so that the image, the whole image is inside the image space provided. So you can see there, it shifts it down a bit, so it contains the whole image. You might see some white space on the sides and whatnot, but if you have product-related images that have white backgrounds like this one does, then that kind of makes sense. But of course, if you want to adjust the image sizes in any way, you can simply adjust them by grabbing on the corners. You can also add your logo, which will appear down here in the URL section. You can upload your own images. You can hide the URL text and another couple of features. This is to generate, if your site has a sitemap, you can, it'll detect your sitemap and then it'll give you an option of all the URLs which you can select from the sitemap to develop, to generate pin from there, but I won't get into that now. This is a new feature, bulk actions. If you like all of your pins that have been set up and you are enjoying and you want to send them all to Pinterest, instead of scheduling all of them one by one by one by one, you can simply click the schedule all pins button and it'll schedule all of those pins to go. Then lastly, you can also search for videos that you would like to add to your pins. So classic good old cat video. Then you just can click and drag that video into your pin and there you go. So you can't immediately schedule video pins, but you can download them and then you will have an idea pin which you can share to Pinterest. So that is Pin Generator in a nutshell. I hope you enjoyed it. And you can save your design settings. And if you love it, please check it out. Please use it for your business. If you need to have any questions answered, just get hold of me. I'm contactable via this little box here, and I'm also contactable via our contact page here. Lovely. Have a great day. Cheers.